Hello, children. My name is Zen, and I'm the Youth and Young Adults Pastor here at Wototo Church. I hope that you've been enjoying all the services because I think they are so cool. Now, for this service, feel free to sing and dance with all your might. Have a lot of fun.
Come on, everyone. Boss. Hi. My name is Uncle Bosco, and I'm with
Uncle Kapale Francis. And we are so happy that you're here with us. Now, I want us to dance together. I want you to stand, get some space. We are going to do a dance challenge between you and us. Woo! When the music stops, pause and take a selfie. So let's go.
Hey!
1, 2, 3!
Selfie!
Let's go! Woo!
Boss!
We go! Woo!
Buzz!
Hey! I believe you've had fun. Now, let's join the worship team as we dance for Jesus.
Let's go!
Hey, sorry.
Come on! Hi, children! I'm so excited to be with you this week. Come on, get up on your feet. Everybody, get up, and let's dance together. Come on, like this. Doing a good job. Come on, let's sing together.
Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good to me. You turn my mourning into dancing, put off my rags, and clothe me with gladness.
Says that this is the day the Lord has made, and we should rejoice and be glad. I am rejoicing. I am happy because you have been expressing yourself to God. I have two beautiful psalms from you. And I want to read them right now. One is from Shalom from Gulu. And it says, Lord, you are good. I love you. You made us and you are good. You made food for us to eat. I love you. You are the Lord and my King. And then the next one is from Ishazi from Bugolobi. And it says, my God, oh Lord, you have saved me from Corona. My God, you love me and I thank you for that. Oh Lord, you are the only God I worship. You are mighty God. My God, even when I am not at school, you are still helping me to learn. You provide for me. What a wonderful God you are to me. Thank you so much, children, for these beautiful psalms. And if you haven't sent any psalm, this is the time. Write them and send them to your aunties and uncles on those WhatsApp groups. So before we dive in our lesson today, I want us to pray. Jesus, we thank you for today. We thank you for the lesson that we are going to learn today. Jesus, may you come and teach us. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. So I want to give you 5 seconds. If you don't have your notebook, your pen, and your Bible, go and get them. Then come and join us. But if you have it with you, open your Bible. Psalm 139. I repeat, Psalm 139. And let's read it together.
Lord, you have examined me. You know all about me. You know when I sit down and when I get up. You know my thoughts before I think them. You know where I go and where I lie down. You know well everything I do. Lord, even before I say a word, you already know what I'm going to say. You are all around me, in front and in back. You have put your hand on me. Your knowledge is amazing to me. It is more than I can understand. Where can I go to get away from your spirit? Where can I run from you? If I go up to the skies, you are there. If I lie down where the dead are, you are there. If I rise with the sun in the east and settle in the west beyond the sea, even there you would guide me. With your right hand, you would hold me. I could say, the darkness will hide me. The light around me will turn into night. But even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as light as day. Darkness and light are the same to you. You made my whole being. You formed me in my mother's body. I will praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. You saw my bones being formed as I took shape in my mother's body. When I was put together there, you saw my body as it was formed. All the days planned for me were written in your book before I was one day old. Lord, your thoughts are precious to me. There are so many. If I could count them, there would be more than all the grains of sand. When I wake up, I am still with you. God, I wish you could kill all the wicked. Get away from me, you murderers. These men say evil things about you. Your enemies use your name thoughtlessly. Lord, I hate those who hate you. I hate those who rise up against you. I feel only hate for them. They are my enemies. God, examine me and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. See if there is any bad thing in me. Lead me in the way you said long ago.
Hello, children. It's such a joy to see each and every one of you. I hope you had an amazing week with your family. Well, we have been on a journey studying from the book of Psalms. First, we learned from Psalm 8, then Psalm 1, then Psalm 23, then Psalm 100, then Psalm 46 last week, and today we are going to learn from Psalm 139. We learned that Psalms were a way in which the people of the Bible expressed themselves to God. And you too have done an amazing job expressing yourselves to God by writing your own psalms, your own songs, and your own poems. I am super proud of each and every one of you. In fact, give me a high five. Woohoo! Today, we are going to learn from Psalm 139. This psalm was written by David. David realized that God knew everything about him. David also knew that God was everywhere. There is no place that David could go where God wasn't. So David expressed himself in Psalm 139. From this psalm, we learn two things. We learn, first of all, that God is all-knowing, he knows everything. And secondly, we learn that God is everywhere. The Bible tells us that God knows everything. That makes him all-knowing. God knows things of the past. God knows things of the future. God even knows things of the present. God does not need to learn anything. God does not need to reason anything. God does not need to relearn anything because God is all-knowing. The best thing is God knows about you. From this psalm, we learn that God knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb. Isn't that amazing? The Bible goes on to tell us that God even knows the number of hair on your head. Such knowledge helps us realize how much God loves us. The fact that he thought about us and placed us in the families that we are in today shows how much God loves us. But secondly, God is everywhere. The Bible tells us in Proverbs chapter 15, verse 3, that the eyes of the Lord are watching evil and good. I'm wondering, when God watches you, does he see evil? Does he see you watching channels you're not supposed to be watching on TV? Does he see you taking things that don't belong to you? Does he see you being mean and rude and disobedient to your parents and guardians? I hope not. I hope that when the Lord sees you, he sees you do good, like being an obedient child, loving, caring for your siblings, being responsible, reading your Bible and praying to the Lord. I hope that is what the Lord sees when he watches you. David realized that there is no place where God isn't on this earth. The Bible tells us in Psalm 139 from verse 7, David said, I can never escape from your spirit. I can never get away from your presence. If I go up to heaven, you are there. If I go down to the grave, you are there. God is everywhere. Even in your best hiding spot, where your mom and dad cannot find you, guess who is there with you in that hiding spot? Of course, God is right there with you. David realized this, and so he expressed his feelings in Psalm 139. Jeremiah was asked a very important question by God. God asked Jeremiah, can a man hide himself in hiding places so that I do not see him? And God asked Jeremiah, do I not feel the heavens and the earth? And of course the answer is, there is nowhere where we can ever hide from God. Lots of people in the Bible realized that God was with them. Hagar, for example, was sent away by her mistress, Sarah. And as she went, she thought she was going to die, but the Lord saved her. Hagar said in Genesis chapter 16, verse 3, that I have remained alive even after seeing God. Rahab in Joshua declared that God is the God of heaven and earth. Amazing. Jacob also said that surely God is in this place. This was the time when Jacob saw a ladder of angels going up and down at a place called Bethel. Surely God is everywhere. Matthew chapter 18 verse 20 tells us that where two or three are gathered, God is there in their midst. And God is everywhere all at the same time. God is with the people in America. He's also with the people in China. He's also with the people in Egypt. He's also with us here in Uganda. But most of all, he is with you right where you are. God is with us. David ends this psalm in prayer. Verses 23 and 24, David asked God to search him, to know his heart. And if there was any sin that was hidden from him, David asked that God would remove it and would lead him along the everlasting path. Nowhere can we ever go and God is not there. In fact, God loves us so much that he sent his one and only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. For us to be with God, we need to accept Jesus as the Lord and the Savior of our lives. For God wants to be with us. If you've never asked Jesus as the Lord and Savior of your life, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Say, dear Jesus, I thank you so much for loving me. Thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross for my sins. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's children say, amen. If you prayed that prayer for the very first time and you meant it from your heart, I want to let you know that you are now saved. You are now born again, and God will always look out for you. Welcome to God's family. Here is our weekly challenge. First, I want you to get a plain sheet of paper and label it "All About Me and God." And I want you to write things that only you and God know about. For example, a new tooth that is growing, or a scar on your back that nobody knows about. And then I want you to take Psalm 139 and make it your own psalm. I want you to put your name where the word "me" is, or your name where the word "my" is. My name is Dora, and this is my psalm. Oh Lord, you have examined Dora's heart. You know everything about Dora. You know when Dora sits or stands. You know Dora's thoughts even from far away. You see Dora when she travels and when Dora rests at home. You know everything Dora does. I want you to go all the way to verse 24. Make it your own. Be creative. Color it up. You can make it in a heart shape, a square. Feel free. But make sure you share a copy with us. I'll be praying for you. I love you so much, and have a blessed week.
I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. Our memory verse is coming from Psalm 139, verse 23 to 24. And it says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. Point out anything in me that offends you, and lead me along the path of eternal life." Now, from our memory verse, we learn that God knows everything about our thoughts, and he knows those bad things that we have done that make him sad. But today, we are asking him to show us those bad things, and also that we might be able to live with him in eternal life when we go to heaven. So friends, I want us to do our memory verse one more time. Are you ready? So, Psalm 139, verse 23 to 24. And it says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. Point out anything in me that offends you, and lead me along the path of eternal life." That is very good. Enjoy the rest of the service.
That was such an amazing lesson. I hope you enjoyed it as well. Come on, get up on your feet and let's continue to praise Jesus. Everybody nice. You're doing so great.
So much. Remember, God loves you and have an amazing week. Bye.